Hello and welcome to the highlights for Directory Opus 13. A text version of this video is linked in the description below. Directory Opus is a file manager similar to File Explorer but much more powerful. Dark mode is now supported for the whole program. But it's not just dark mode and light mode, it's any colours you like mode. Hundreds of colours can now be configured and most give immediate feedback to changes. Dialogues, buttons, checkboxes and other controls can all be recolored. And if you're on Windows 11, you can throw its scroll bars in the trash where they belong. More fonts can be adjusted, and this includes those used in dialogues and info tips. When copying files, placeholders appear in the destination to show items which are about to be copied. Progress dialogues and speed graphs have been redesigned and performance has been improved. When copying between drives on the same server, all the data had to come to your machine and then go back again. Server-side offloading allows the copy to be done directly instead of going over the network. Everything, a popular index search tool, can now be used to search the current folder or your whole machine. This also allows for instant folder size calculation within indexed folders. Expandable folders allow you to open subfolders and work on files in multiple levels at once. The default toolbars include some new commands for working with these. The Favorites bar lets you create folder shortcuts via drag and drop. You can middle-click these to open them in a new tab. The new Setlist of Defaults dialog makes it easier to choose your default columns, toolbars, and window layout. Changes to how different folders are displayed can now be saved automatically. So if you change the columns or view mode in a folder, it will be the same again when you go back to it. This can be used in conjunction with the old folder format system or turned off entirely. Paired folders allow you to link two paths in various ways. For example, you can have a button which swaps between two folder hierarchies. Or, if you start in one path and open the dual file display, it can show you the pair side by side. Combine this with navigation lock to keep the two sides in step. A summary of selected file extensions can now be displayed on the status bar. This helps know what's selected when you can't see everything at once. Click on it for an interactive pie chart. The folder tree's indentation and spacing can now be adjusted. The inexplicable jumble of shortcuts which Windows 11 adds under the desktop branch is now hidden by default. Tree routes can be reordered or turned off entirely, and cloud storage can now be moved to its own section. There's a new button to collapse everything except the active branch, and a preset system lets you save and restore which branches are open. Branches can also be pinned to prevent them being closed. The list of network servers can be cached across restarts, and you can control which machines are included. Thumbnails mode has improved display of long file names and Find As You Type highlights. You can now choose how thumbnails are scaled and if they are cropped. And thumbnail size and scaling can be overridden on a per folder basis. It's now possible to define custom folder thumbnail styles similar to the built-in CD dual cases. This example shows a Blu-ray case which is used as the thumbnail frame for folders with specially named cover art. A new option prevents closure of locked folder tabs. The folder tab context menu can now be edited, and a new tab switcher opens if you push the Control and Tab keys. If a lot of tabs are open, the mouse wheel can now scroll them, whether the tab bar is horizontal or vertical. Find As You Type has several new modes. Type a single quote into the file display to search the current folder with Opus. Or type a plus sign to search your whole machine with everything. Type a square bracket, then part of a name, to quickly navigate to a folder from a configurable list of sources. When highlighting names in the current folder, Ctrl-S selects all matches, F3 jumps to the next match, and marks on the scroll bar let you see if there are more matches scrolled out of view. When entering ad hoc commands, pop-ups now help with command and argument names. Scripts can also add custom modes and respond to what you type. This is very open-ended, but in this example, a script automatically recognises abbreviations of folder names below a specified path. So if I type GBA, it finds the Game Boy Advance folder, even though those characters are not together in its name. The viewer has a new video player based on modern APIs. Videos can go full screen from the preview pane, and the player supports both DirectShow and codecs from the Microsoft Store. Audio files play with cover art, and autoplay and auto-mute can be configured separately for audio and video. Microsoft Edge can be used in the preview pane, providing a modern viewer for web content. Edge can also handle PDF files if you prefer it to the other options. Lister linked viewers let you turn a second monitor into a full screen preview pane. So the full screen viewer on the screen on the right tracks the selection in the Lister on the left, and vice versa. The toolbar hidden at the top of full screen viewers has new buttons to move it between monitors. Pushing F3 in the viewer toggles between dark and light backgrounds. You can go to GPS coordinates via a configurable list of mapping services. While drag selecting part of an image, holding space allows you to adjust the starting point. And you can now view images in the AVIF and Direct Draw Surface formats. The Image Converter has a new user interface with support for user-defined presets. Presets can be used in the converter itself or directly from the file display. Lossless JPEG can now be turned off in the UI for when you need to force recompression. Batch cropping of images is now possible, and you can edit the list of predefined resize options. Video metadata now uses the Media Info Library with support for more formats and information. The status bar can show media durations without triggering calculation of them. Durations will be shown there if they've already been calculated by something else. ID3 V2 tags are now supported in WAV files. The metadata editor has a new option for decimal GPS coordinates, and there are new options for editing multi-value fields which differ across the selected files. So values can be added instead of replacing everything that was there, and you can also remove individual values as well. Finally, for metadata, the music genre list can now be edited. You can now define custom hotkeys to select or modify parts of file names when renaming. These can work using regular expressions, rename presets, or even scripts. Inline rename is now very quick and powerful. While these hotkeys work in most places where file names are edited, there are still some tasks where you'll want the full rename dialog. Back in Inline Rename, suggestions can appear based on previous renames. The Find panel has a new design. Presets let you save and load the panel's configuration, and you can change what happens when you reset. Excluding unwanted folders is now easier. Index search using Windows Search or Everything can be used as a starting point, which is then filtered by the other options. Find presets can also be accessed via the Tools menu without opening the Find panel at all. In any word mode, you can include and exclude words with plus and minus and match names without worrying about word order. Advanced filters can now match folders by their content. For example, this finds all folders containing movies or images. Filters can now be edited as text. This allows for self-contained commands and scripts which use filters or even generate them on the fly. The Duplicate File Finder also has support for presets and easier folder exclusion. It's now easier to select duplicates by location, and duplicate searches using data hashes are now faster. Synchronize also has presets. Performance has been improved when dealing with large folders. An option has been added to sync files that are normally hidden, and another option allows you to keep files which are larger or smaller. You now have three choices for how recent dates are displayed. When there are too many columns to fit on screen, you can now freeze some of the columns on the left so they remain visible when the others scroll. You can now copy data from columns to the clipboard. Hold Ctrl and drag with the right button, then right-click the selection and choose a format. Unicode directional overrides can be used to obscure a file's real extension. A new option will filter those from file names so you don't get fooled. There's also an option to preserve the file extension when there isn't room for the whole name. Importing columns from File Explorer is now as easy as choosing the one you want and turning it on. Custom columns can now be defined using simplified scripting. Custom ways to group things can also be defined in a similar way. Many preferences pages now include descriptions to help understand them and links to related pages. Clicking the info icon at the top of a page will toggle its description to save space. Pages which you use a lot can be added to a section at the top of the list for easy access. And the new privacy page lets you clear or suppress suggestions based on history and previous actions. The customized dialog is no longer always on top. When Customize is open, Lister title bars have buttons to show, OK, or cancel it without having to find its window. The list of pre-made commands you can drag to your toolbars has been greatly expanded. Another new tab displays the built-in default toolbars, and this lets you drag or inspect the default commands without having to factory reset your real toolbars. Moving the slider on the left will highlight items added in different versions of Opus. The list of hotkeys can now be filtered by category, and it has separate fields at the bottom to search for keys and commands. The command editor makes suggestions as you type. When using codes to insert file names and paths into commands, the editor can now display the lines as they are generated, showing you what the codes expand into and the order in which files are processed. Finally, a new script IDE is included for editing script add-ins. This is especially useful for scripts which use custom dialogues. So, those were the highlights for version 13. If you want even more, see the detailed list of changes, which is linked in the description below. Let us know if you'd like deeper coverage of any features, new or old, and thank you very much for watching to the end. Bye bye!